There are many new features being added to the December update of the InfoRiver Visual Professional Edition. The biggest one coming out is the ability to export to Excel. The export experience has been streamlined for the Professional Edition, and any rows that you see visible at the time of export will show up in the Excel file. So as an example, let's start by coming up to the Home ribbon and selecting Export, and we'll be given an option to right-click Save Link As, and I'll save this to Desktop. And you can see that it exported all rows and columns, including formatting as well for both the font and the background. Now let's go ahead and hide the Contoso categories below it and see what happens on the export. I'm going to come over here and collapse the Contoso level of the hierarchy. And again, let's go to Export, right-click and Save As, and save a new version. And you can see that because it was not visible in InfoRiver at the time of export, we are now just given one row for Contoso without the product category below it. Additionally, the navigation that you choose up here, whether or not it is hierarchy or table, will also be captured as part of the export. If I set this to table, come over to export, and make another copy, we can see that it exported it in more of the classic table layout as configured in InfoRiver in the service, while still keeping both the font and background color formatting. Commenting is also supported in the export as well. If I was to come to this cell, select add a new comment, type in a comment here, select save, this comment will be included as part of the export. Additionally, if we come over here and we select the notes column, we'll get a remarks column over on the right. And if I was to add some commentary over here, that's now saved in the table. So let's come up to export, save this to desktop, click save. We can now see that the note has been added into this cell, and we also have the remarks column that was added over on the right. The experience for measure level formatting has also been significantly improved. As an example, if I was to select sales over here, notice that there are sales in other categories on the columns as well. I can quickly and easily select all of them to format by coming up to the options here, choosing Select Measure, which will then select the measure across all of the column categories. I can now then quickly and easily come up to Format and customize the measure here. You can also apply any style edits at the measure level as well. As an example, I can increase the font size or change the color as necessary. Another great formatting update is the ability to apply formatting to the entire hierarchy level. Let's use the example of wanting to highlight levels of our Regged hierarchy. I'm going to come up to the background color, select a light gray background to highlight it, come up to the Format Painter, select Apply Format to Level, and then as you'll see as we can scroll down, the Regged hierarchy levels that we have visible below the companies will show up on any of these levels as we see in the entire table. We've also updated and refined the new user experience when creating new calculations. You can observe that if you come up to Advanced, go to Insert Formula, and you can see that there's a new option here at the top to insert as either a visual measure or a visual column. Notice how the visual measure adds it for each of the column categories, whereas if you select visual column, and I'm going to scroll over to the far right, you'll see that it created a new column category plus a new column within that new category as well. Let's go ahead and select visual measure, rename this to variance. In the formula, I'll put sales minus forecast, and the rest of the experience in here is the same as it was before. Let's create, and there we have our new calculation. We've also made the data bar's conditional formatting a lot more robust. Let's go ahead and select year-over-year sales percentage as a column, come up to conditional formatting, select data bars, I'll go ahead and pick the blue for the top color, change the hierarchy levels to values and totals, and then change the negative value color to a lighter red, select apply, and we have one other type of data bar that can be applied. If I close out of this, I'm gonna come over to sales, conditional formatting and data bars again, select the blue one, and you'll notice that we have an option for gradient colors. If the condition is met where all of the values in the column are positive, then you instead of a positive and negative color choice, you get a min and max gradient with the ability to specify the color gradient between the two with customizing the individual colors, plus also choosing the alignment of either left or right. If I select right, select apply, you'll see that it switches to the other side depending on the data and the type of information you want to display. We've also included an option to hide individual nodes of a hierarchy if needed. As an example, if I want to show discounts, but I don't want to show the sensitive information below this, I can come up to the menu for discounts, go to hide icon, which will then hide the lower level below discounts while still allowing this to roll up to the grand total. Additionally, I can come up to display, go over to hierarchy, and under customized levels, I can open this up, and then for any specific hierarchy, I can choose to hide that entire level from the end user experience. We've also added multiple ways to quickly and easily adjust the row height at many different levels. We have an option up here on the Home ribbon to use the up or down arrows to individually adjust the pixels of all of the rows across the table. So if we moved that down, we can see all of them adjusting equally. Now, if I was to select a specific row and use this again, then that will adjust the row height to that specific row. Additionally, I can come over to the Format Painter, And I can select Apply Format to Level, which will apply that row height to all of the rows at that level. Additionally, we can come up and select the Real option, and then I have the option for both columns and rows over here to use the mouse to be able to drag and drop these to any respective row height that I want. And similarly, I can select that row again if I wanted to and use the Apply Format to Level option. Another method is coming over to Display, coming over to Hierarchy, and I can also choose to add padding to any of the parent hierarchies. If I was to add 10 here, you can see the changes take effect in the table. Additionally, you can add row padding by inserting a blank row. As an example, I want to add some padding right here between operating profit and discount. So I'm going to select this, go to Insert, Add Static Row. I'm going to keep the name as New Row, select Create, come up to the font color and change that to white. And there we go. That blank row has now inserted some padding between sections of the data as I want to divide it up across different rows and categories. And last but not least, you can fine-tune the report to a pixel-perfect fit by adjusting the zoom down in the lower right. As an example, there's a little bit of the numbers that are bleeding over here into the report itself, so if I was to adjust this to a slightly higher number, such as 102, you'll see that it is now perfectly sized this onto the report canvas. Users also have the option to configure the type of aggregation for the data showing on the page. In this example right now, below the subcategory level, I have the sales order IDs in here. So if I was actually to come up to Advanced, come over to Aggregation, and as an example, change that to Maximum, I'll now be given at every subtotal level the maximum order amount based off of sales order ID. Additionally, with that new feature that we have, we can also come up to the Home ribbon, go to Display, go to the Hierarchy, come over to Customize Levels, and turn off the ability to drill down all the way to the order level, which gives us the option to choose the aggregation at the order level, but only display things at a higher level in the hierarchy. We've also added some additional formatting features. As one example, if you were to go ahead and turn on the rails, you can now select the upper left cell, which will allow you to customize the row category name, which gives us the flexibility to do things such as underline, choose the alignment, and other features. We've also added a filter feature in Manage Columns. If I was to search for sales, it will filter my list down to only calculations or columns that contain the word sales in it. We've also added multiple easy-to-use templates for the header and footer. To access those, either double-click on the header, come over to the Edit icon here on the right, or come up to Advanced and select Header and Footer. To start with, let's come over to the header preset and select that, and you can see that we have a few different options that contains a series of formats, as well as an option to either add a logo. Also, you can add KPIs in addition to the logo and report information. Let's go ahead and select the KPI one. Close out of this window. Now notice that these two cards that were automatically created are using a feature to extract data from a specific cell. Essentially, it used this option up here of cell value, in this case, to get all Australia variants and all Australia forecast. If we close this here, you'll see that it retrieves the value plus provides a title. Notice as well that it includes the conditional formatting such as colors and the KPI icon that was originally applied to the column. Additionally, if we come back and click on the header here, we have the option to customize this as well. Any of these cards and quadrants here can be resized individually with the ability to split them as well, either vertically or horizontally. If we select that, we'll see that it's actually now split into two different sections where we can add additional information. In this new box, we have options to add things such as page number, date, various symbols, or again, we can have a cell value in here where we retrieve a certain bit of information from the table itself, which will then grab that data as it refreshes or gets filtered by the report itself. Last but not least, we have a few formatting options as well where we can access superscript or subscript, plus the option to fill or add a shadow to any of these card boxes. And last but not least, the Smart Analysis feature can be incredibly handy on P&L statements and similar reports. As an example, if we were wanting to compare operating profit with any of the other values that we have in here, we can come up to Advanced, let's select Actuals for operating profit as the actual comparison, come up to Smart Analysis, and we can choose Contribution, which will create a new column called Actuals Percent of Operating Profit, and it compares this value to any of the other values on the rows in here. Additionally, we can come back up to this, select Smart Analysis, and we can also choose a variance instead. This column is also configurable, so you could actually take it and move it over next to your Actuals, to make it easier to scan down your rows and do a financial horizontal analysis.